Hi, my name is Joshua Won Park Kim, and welcome to Park Kim Lectures. Now, in this series, I basically do a music educational-based lectures on YouTube. Now, the thing that I'm doing at the moment is giving you a bit of an explanation of classical music and music that has been appeared in films and television. But this episode is just going to be a little bit of a twist because I was basically talking about movies and television shows that uses classical music. In today's episode, we're going to be talking about film music composition. And because this is Christmas, we've been talking about Home Alone. Now, I know some of you guys might be confused because I've talked in the previous episode I'll be doing Winter Sonata, but we're in Christmas season, so I decided to do, you know, let me just push that to the side and talk about the Christmas movies first. So here I am. And also thank you for the new subscribers and new viewers for this video because I've finally reached 200 subscribers. The composer of this movie, Home Alone, is the great John Williams. John Williams is the guy who's holding 5 little golden statues. Damn! 5 Oscars! According to Chris Columbus, the first poster of Home Alone, the composer was supposed to be Bruce Broughton.
John Williams was not the original composer. If you have one of the early posters of Home Alone, which you probably got a couple in your attic somewhere.
Somewhere.
It says composer Bruce Broughton. And Bruce Broughton was the original composer on a film that I wrote called Young Sherlock Holmes. And I loved his score for that film, so I met with him and hired him for this. Essentially, he was doing The Rescuers Down Under. I think that's what it was. So we lost him. So we had no composer while we were shooting.
And so that's why he desperately went to Steven Spielberg asking for a composer, and that is when he met John Williams.
We went to John Williams thinking he'll never do a film like this, but he saw the film, loved it, and decided to...
It was amazing what he did,
his
too.
His score is unbelievable. Yeah. His score is beautiful.
He doesn't miss.
No.
So John Williams is a composer who wrote music for Star Wars, Indiana Jones, Jaws, Schindler's List, and all the films by Steven Spielberg, except for a couple of them like West Side Story. And also Williams composed a film directed by Columbus, which was the Harry Potter films, including The Philosopher's Stone and The Chamber of Secrets.
Well, the thing is, comedy is very difficult to score because it can always sound stupid or goofy. Mm-hmm. And John never really let that happen.
Okay, so the people who haven't seen the movie Home Alone, wow, really? You haven't seen Home Alone. Ugh, this is such a disgrace. All right, so I'll give you a little bit of a brief explanation of what this movie is about. So, okay, here we go. It's a movie about a big family, a huge family with lots and lots of people. And as you can see, they're basically fucking rich because they have a big house and they're preparing for a Christmas vacation to Paris. And on the day when they were getting to the airport, they were in a desperate situation because they were about to be late. And because of being so desperate, they completely forgot about their 8-year-old son, Kevin McAllister. And so that's why this boy has been left home alone.
The main villain of this movie is these two burglars named Marv and Harry, and they're planning to break into their house after the whole family goes on to their vacation. But they don't even know that there is an 8-year-old boy left in that house alone. And so when these guys break into Kevin's house... I think this kid has some problems. Holy shit.
When we talk about the musical composition in this movie, there's a bit of a surprise. And John Williams is a genius when it comes to writing music for movies. Now, the reason why I consider John Williams to be a genius is because he's doing something that composers should never ever do, which is copying. So the problem with John Williams is that he's copying other people's compositions and making it into his own thing and calling it as an original soundtrack. And he already did that to many, many film compositions. I talked about this in my 11th lecture where I compared between copying, plagiarizing, and the topic about public domain. So what is a public domain? Public domain is a composition or any creative work that is free for anyone to use. You know how there's a new composer who wrote a new composition and somehow when you post it up on YouTube, you get copyright claimed or copyright struck. So what about music that is public domain? You don't get copyright claimed, you don't get copyright strike, and you don't need to worry about anything about copyright issues. So what kind of music is part of public domain? The public domain compositions are usually compositions composed after the death of a composer around 50 to 70 years. So that's why all classical music written by a composer died after 70 or 50 years is free, completely free. Now this music is played when the whole family realized, oh shit, we're gonna be late for the plane. Still, John Williams wanted to bring up that Christmas feeling and that Christmas mood, so that's why he used one of the most famous Christmas classical music, which is known as Tchaikovsky's ballet, Nutcracker. When you listen to this, you're like, yeah, it is a bit copied, but it's not really 100% copied, isn't it? And so the question over here is it okay to copy other people's compositions like that? So there's four ways of copying other people's composition and making it into your own thing. A, stealing. Two, paraphrasing. And D, pastiche and musical quotation.
Stealing is when you're literally stealing someone else's composition and making it as your own original composition. Take a listen to this Star Wars theme by John Williams. And now to the King's Row theme by Korngold. Not convinced? Okay, then how about this one? And the part of Gustav Holst's Mars. Still not convinced? Okay, then what about this one? Which is taken from Still not convinced? Well, be convinced! Pastiche is when you're imitating something and making your own version more memorable than the original. Now, I already talked about this in my 7th lecture where I talked about pastiche and parody. Now, in one of the famous parody film, Naked Gun 3 from 1994, you'll be able to see this ridiculous scene, which is actually a parody of this 1987 film, The Untouchables. So, this is the original scene. However, this quote-unquote original scene is not entirely original because this is imitating, aka pastiche, of this 1925 silent film, Battleship Potemkin. Pastiche is when you're imitating something, but it could sometimes be better than the original. So, I believe this Home Alone soundtrack is more of a pastiche than stealing. Now, finally, musical quotation. Musical quotation is directly quoting from another composition, which is exactly what's happening in the Home Alone film. In this scene, we first heard the children choir singing Carol of the Bells, and then Williams took that and made it into this. And I have to say, this is one of my favorite soundtracks of this entire movie. It combines with the Carol of the Bells and along with John Williams' original soundtrack for this movie, Star of the Bethlehem. I didn't explain paraphrase because I didn't want to explain this too much, so please watch my 28th lecture instead where I explain music paraphrasing in detail.
Alright, before I end this episode, how dare you call me an alien bug?
You need to work on the lighting. It reflects in your glasses and make you look like an alien bug with purple laser eyes that shoots acid into the face of Garfield and Christian. Assuming it's the lighting, of course, and that you're not actually an alien bug with laser eyes. Alternatively, you can also...
Why did you write also twice?
Try to do away with the glasses just for the front-facing shot. And yes, the glasses are part of your branding recognition.
Now, first of all, How did you know that was an alien bug? Anyways, my apologies about the thing that I had this ring light in my eyes. So that's why today I had no ring light. I'm gonna be changing the concept and I'll do a little bit differently to make my face so shiny. So, I'll see you guys in a bit. Do you agree with my lecture? If you disagree or if you have any other topics that you want me to talk about, leave the comment down below. Then I'll see you in the next lecture. My name is Joshua Won Parkim, and as always, take care.